Salutations, this is Grim Davel. Welcome to our Let's Try of MAIA, M-A-I-A, MAIA. MAIA is a game that I found out about because I follow the Mojang, the company Mojang, they make Minecraft. I follow their like employee Twitter list, and one of their employees, who goes by the handle of Sarge, a month or two ago, had a tweet about this game, MAIA, because there was a new release of it, and how he thought it got better with every iteration. And I saw it was on sale on Steam at that time, and I bought it. And I haven't really had a chance to play it until now. I wanted to make sure I had some time to actually, you know, do this. And we've just had other games that we've been wanting to play. But I'm excited to be playing this now. This game is supposed to be a dungeon keeper meets Dwarf Fortress slash RimWorld slash like a 1970s space, like XCOM or Aliens sort of thing. So I'm excited, and I gotta admit, this is not the first time I tried recording this. I have about 20 minutes of me flailing through it and realized that the learning curve for this game is way too hard. It's basically just 20 minutes of me trying to figure out the controls and commands, and all of my colonists just asphyxiated, and I had no idea what I was doing. Everyone was just standing around doing nothing. And so while I thought that might be fun to watch me just try it for the first time, it was not that entertaining. If you guys want to see it, if I get enough like response saying, oh, I'd really like to see that like flail through, I'll show it to you. But this time we're gonna play, there's a tutorial, yeah, right here, and I think we gotta start with this. We're gonna just watch me play the tutorial today. We're just gonna go through the tutorial, because it's really hard to learn the controls any other way. Okay, so welcome to 3452. See, MAIA, Planetfall has been a success. Your objective now is a self-sustaining colony that can begin work on larger, more permanent projects. Also, just so you guys know, this game is very much in alpha, so please forgive the developers for any bugs. I think it's been in development since at least 2012, so it has been a while, but it is still in alpha. Let's see. It is impossible to directly control colonists. That technology has not been invented. We must satisfy ourselves with the technology we have developed for watching them. Press Y to confirm you have read the text and are capable of obeying simple instructions. Okay. Press W, S, A, and D to move the camera. Press and hold the middle mouse button to rotate. Right, and the rotating is like inverse from what I want it to be, and there's no way to change that. That's okay. Scroll, sit up straight, take deep breaths. Okay. So we have a kitty. We have colonists. Z McDonald, she seems upset. We got a progress report. We have a robot. Williams Cooper. We have all these colonists. We have water barrels, ration packs. Oh, okay. Now, hold, okay, good. Now scroll. Yeah, we did it. Okay, and sit up straight, take deep breaths. Okay, to issue construction orders, click on the build buttons below. The square box blueprint icon lets you place rooms. Use the 0 through 9 keys to merrily cycle through the rooms available to you. Click and drag to place room tiles. Double clicking can also be used to automatically fill an area. Right clicking lets you delete rooms. Large rooms are always preferable. Colonists are no longer trapped on a ship. They need space. Once you have placed the blueprints, your colonists will build the rooms in a situ. I think it means suite. Please press Y to demonstrate your obedience. If possible, use a clean finger. I'll do my best. Okay, rooms. I guess we'll place store. You can only build a workshop now. Is this storage? Is that the same thing as press 4? Oh. So even like hitting 1 through 9 here, that is something on my first like flail through, I did not understand. I couldn't figure out how to actually place rooms. So we're gonna double click and make this workshop. Tell me about your mother. Well, my mother, okay, all right, that's fine. Mining allows your colonists to collect minerals to smelt for building minerals. Materials and create space to build new rooms. You can issue mining orders to your IMP robot. Clicking on the, it's cute, it calls it an IMP, like an imp, like in Dungeon Keeper. Imp robot by clicking on the top of the rock cross sections. Press Y now, right now. Okay, enter interaction mode by clicking on the hand. Click the robot icon on the bottom left to find an imp. Cool. Place 3 dig orders by clicking reachable rock areas. Okay. Oh, here, I guess. Are there more? Right here? Oh, great, great. No, wait, that's 1, 2, 3. Okay. The tool icon lets you place items. Use Q and E. This is something else I didn't get in my flail through. I didn't know that you could, like, cycle through items this way. I had a really hard time. They are context sensitive and will change according to the room or area that your mouse is currently hovering over. So this stuff, this game, I think once you understand the instructions, it does look really fun, but it is not intuitive without doing this tutorial. More construction options will become available as you research. To have something disassembled or an order canceled, press the interaction mode icon and then right-click on the object. Press Y for a tasty treat. As a meteor event. As a base grows or casualties rise, it will need more colonists. On the bottom right hand of the screen is a lander icon. This counts down to the next suitable colonist drop window. Clicking it will call down a new crew vehicle of colonists. Okay, cool. So click on the flashing item placement icon. Okay, a workshop table? I suppose so. Plant pot. Yeah, so is this the workshop that we just built? I guess so. Okay, yeah, let's put in a workshop table. How do I rotate it? Can I rotate it? Move over a wall to place a door. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah, it needs a door, right? Right there. Air vent system, condenser unit. Okay, so these are all things you could put in a wall, but we want a door. Okay. And we're going to put a workshop table in the workshop. Is there a way I can... No. Sure, we'll listen to your avant-garde electronic music. Oh, thank you. Meteors are coming. Okay, great. Great, I don't care. Okay, workshop table. All right, I guess I can't rotate it. Oh, there we go, if I drag it. Okay. All right, so let's... Oh, whoops. Wait. Can I just put it like right there? Okay, great, done. Right, is that done? Are they gonna do that? Wait, nope. Continue. Yeah, how do I confirm? I think that's done, right? I mean, we did that. We did it. Okay, great. The base manifest provides a quick overview of the state and supplies of your colony. Mouse over the icon on the top left. To view it. Remember, it lacks context and is no substitute to manually viewing. So it's going too fast. All right. Oh, yeah, great. Why? Okay. To build further equipment, such as atmosphere generators to produce air, we'll need more building materials. A microwave smelter will break down minerals mined by the IMP robots. First, power is required. Solar, wind, and geothermal are immediately available. You can prioritize items for building by double-clicking them in the interaction mode. Why is everything gray? Okay. What are these, interaction mode. No. Okay. Base manifest. Okay. So you just hover over this. Food remaining 2 days. We have no building materials left. We just ran out. Water barrels, ration packs. How do we pause it? Can we pause it? People drinking water, got a robot. Place a wind turbine, okay. I shall do so. Near the airlock, okay. Can I do it like right now? Right here, sure. Okay, it doesn't look like, it looks like just the base rotates, not the blade, so whatever. Okay. What? It's hard to understand her. Okay, so place a smelter in the workshop. Smelter. Oh, there we go, okay. Yeah, we can just put that in the corner over here. Sure, wait, nanoscale 3D printer. Stop. No. Wait, get rid of that. That's not what I wanted. I wanted a smelter. There we go. Right there, great. Okay, place an atmosphere generator in the workshop. Where's that? I'm not sure. Oh, okay. Yeah, right there. Great. Okay, food is a longer-term priority. It is best to get started early. Vegetables and fruit can be grown in a hydroponics room, just like RimWorld. Crops grow at different rates and a varying nutritional value. Potatoes grow quickly. Very RimWorld. Mark out an area for digging large enough for a new room by clicking on the top of the rock in an interaction mode. Once it's dug out, place a large hydroponics area. Don't forget to put a door. Okay. So, interaction, and we're going to mine out the rest of this room. This inverse stuff is going to drive me crazy. Okay. So we're going to mine this out. 1, 2, 3, 4 by 4. Does that make sense? This is 1, 2, 3. I would like, this would be nice, right? 4 by 5? Is this workshop 4 by 5? I'm not quite sure. Oh, I see. Oh no. Wait, I want to put stuff back here. Wait, take that off. I should have just mined. Oh well. Actually, I guess it's fine. Right? I guess. I don't know. Yeah, whatever. This is fine. Mine all this out. In fact, maybe we should mine this out as well. And then we'll put a door, like, right here. So. Okay. So he'll do that, the little imp robot. And we can, maybe we can just start putting the hydroponics here. There we go. What is that noise? I don't like that. What? I cannot understand what they're saying. What? I don't like that beeping. I feel like something's wrong. Okay, so they built power. We have power. One pack of building materials. Water barrels. Oh! Colonist request. No, I do not read the emails you sent. Microwave spelter will break down items. Power is required. Yeah, we know that. How about you? Base manifest. Yes, we know that. Yeah. Great. Yeah, I know we have a workshop table now. These are old emails. How do I pause it? Dig out an area to place hydroponics. We're doing that. Add a door to create a path into the room. Well, do we actually need to do that? Because isn't there already a door here? Now we can put a door here, right? Door. Switch generator, can I move this? Is this moving it or building a new one? Oh, no. Wait, no. I keep hitting space to pause it. Don't get rid of it. I want to build a door. I can't do it. All right, place 3 potato planters. It looks like our thingamabob is done here. Oh, wait. Yeah, is this not? All right, so I guess we do need a door here. Okay. And then hydroponics. Objects. Hydroponics. Fruit tree. Yeah. Fine, just put it in there. Put a few of them in here. I'm gonna make sure they're all green. Okay. I guess those are potato. Wait, are those potato plant? Oh, whoops. No. Get rid of these. We need them to be potato planters. There we go. Potato.
Hydroponics.
Potato. Okay. The rock walls will sap heat. A colony needs to be kept warm, of course. Look for visible breath and shaking from your colonists as a warning sign. Many things will warm the rooms, including waste heat from electrical items, chemical reactions, even from the base's residents themselves. But to directly heat, you must employ space heaters. Place a space heater on the wall of the hydroponics by mousing over the wall. Okay. Yes. Let's do this wall here. Air vent, space heater. You may wish to continue by satisfying your power storage needs and building a living area with food preparation facilities. Remember that average human can survive 3 weeks without food, 3 days without water, 1 minute without air, but your results may vary. Your colonists have many needs, from safety to social contact. Read their emails, watch them closely. Do not keep your base environment pressurized. The outside air is not breathable. By clicking the Y button, you acknowledge you are now wholly responsible for the safety and well-being of each and every one of my pioneers, possessing as you do the ethical, intellectual, and organizational capacity necessary for command. Oh yeah, and they're all gonna die immediately. Don't panic. All right, I'll try not to panic. But this is a lot nicer now that I'm doing this tutorial than it was before. Why is this airlock open? That's what I wanna know. Who is this dude? I feel weird about this. Okay, let's look at these emails. Well, let's look at this for a sec. We have water, we have food. 1 day of food. All right, so we definitely need to mine out more materials. Are you stuck in here? Yeah, we can expand that. There we go. And hopefully the robot will get in there. But there are just like holes in here. I don't like that the robot's stuck. Okay, now the robot's not stuck. Great. Okay. Can we put the door here now? No. Cannot put a door there. That's okay. Meteor warnings. All right, let's look at some of these emails first. Progress report. Without beds, we need beds. And repair bots. Okay. Power systems. We are generating power. We don't have demand. We don't have storage. Okay. Food is long-term priority. Yeah. All right, Leah, let's get food going. The living area that he was talking about. Let's continue to mine. And I guess we'll have the living area near the hydroponics. Right? So let's keep going, like, this way. What? No, I don't want to read it. Okay. I don't know if I need to mine out as much stuff as I am, but...
Low temperature warning in hydroponics.
And just get rid of these. Like, shouldn't we be able to expand our areas here? Like our workshop rooms. Make it workshop. Yeah, just expand the workshop, right? And here too, why not, right? Okay. All right, we are mining in here. How do I get another? Can I like tell them to build something specific? Whoa, no. Whoops, that was a mistake. Okay. Yeah, let's have this be a workshop. Cool. And this stuff too? Sure. And this can be part of the hydroponics, I guess?
Low power.
I don't know. This is a little weird. What is this room? Oh, nah! No! This is storage. I keep right... Oh, no, not that. Storage. There we go. There should be storage. Okay. I don't know what's happening. I'm really confused. Should this be a door? Okay, it is a door. Okay. I messed things up. I probably should have left some rock walls in between everything, because this is a little ridiculous. Rooms, workshop. This should all be workshop. What's going on here? Look at this. We need a. Does it need to be a door? Yeah. Okay. This is stupid. Okay. I really messed things up here. I don't know how they... Okay, it just takes them a while to do these things. We really need to mine this out here, though, so that we can get our living quarters. I'm not helping out by destroying stuff that we've already built. Let's make more space heaters, maybe? I can... Well, everyone can hang out in the hydroponics room, I guess. No, come on. Imp. Here, over here, mine out this. Can he do that? Can I put a door like... No. Can I mine that stuff out over there? I'm a little confused. Casualty! Hypothermia! No! Okay, well, we had someone die of hypothermia. It's really cold. Alright, let's put more space heaters, like one... Here?
Storage area.
Yeah, we'll put one in here too, sure. Space heater. No, put it on this side. Where is it? Space heater. Just... I can't put a space heater in this room? Okay. Well, we have one in here. Hydroponics. They are potatoes. Okay. What are these? Well, we lost a colonist. Do we get more? Yeah, okay. Let's get more colonists here. We'll probably need more power soon. Okay. So space just, like, jumps you around from place to place. Where is our no, not that. Our robot. Okay. Are you going to mine? I really want you to mine. Are you going to do that? No. Why not? No. Mine it. Do you need a door to do that? Door. Right here? Out here? Yeah, I guess out here. Put a door there, and then maybe you can get out and mine that. Okay. Look at this. This is all messed up. Might as well just mine out all that stuff. Hungry creatures. All foliage. Yeah, sure, make the order. We're gonna destroy foliage. Oh, look at that, okay. It's probably really cold out there, though. I hope they're okay. This seems really dumb. Can I destroy this door? Yeah. Yeah. Destroy these doors. And this room casing, can I destroy? This also seems dumb. What is going on here? We have... This is so weird. What if I make these doors? No, I can't do that. I'm gonna door there. Alright, where's the robot? Oh, the robot's doing this stuff. Okay. I need you to work on this stuff. Okay, they just got rid of that. That's good. They can't get to their smelter though, can they? Oh wait, she's in the smelter. Okay, so I guess they can, or maybe she's trapped in there, I don't know. We really need living quarters. I need them to mine this out. There's a space heater there. Okay, where are you going? Robot. Uh-huh. We got some rubble here. Minerals, great. It's definitely cold in here. I really want to put a space heater in here. But I don't seem to be able to. What is he doing? What is that guy? Why isn't he mining that robot? I even told, or at least building that door there so we can mine. Or the people need to build the door, I guess. All right, a little confusing. All right, build a door, please. Mr. Anderson. Miss Anderson? Mr. Anderson? Not sure. I know, it's cold. Although it's this room is space heated, right? Okay, now that robot should be able to mine, I think. We have no food left. We really need food. Turrets, work light, atmosphere generator. Should probably do that, right? Generate atmosphere. Yeah. Let's just put one out in here. All right, are you mining yet, stupid robot? What are you? All right, I think I can take control of him. Okay, this is just like Dungeon Keeper. Oh, hello, little poodle. All right, here's the storage area. We need to go over here and mine. Whoops. Ah. Go in here. Over. Can I not get over there? Is that the problem? Alright. Alright, get out of... Whoops. Continue. Right click. No, what did I just put... No! I don't want to put minerals there. Okay. How do I get out of you? Q, space, right? No. All right, I don't know how to get out of this guy. Oh, tab, disconnect, right, okay. All right, here's what we're gonna do. We're going to mine these so that you can get to those other areas. And that should work. There we go. Rations low, I know, we're trying. Trying our best here. Clearly, I don't understand, like, when you make rooms, how that actually works. In terms of, like, accessibility. What's supposed to be here? Generic room casing. Rooms. Storage. Storage right there. Alright, those should both be storage. Cool. Big workshop here. Workshop. Yeah. Okay, whatever. And let's also try to mine this out. I guess all this. Okay. Oh! Crop die-off. Discoloration on hydroponics. Set fire to the growth medium. What? But we don't have any food. No, don't do it. We don't have any food. All right, so what we need over here is a colonist. Well, okay. Let me think. So this was supposed to be all hydroponics, I think, up to here. And then we need a, rooms, a living area. Living area? Livestock containment, medical. I think living area. So let's say, like, this area needs to be a living area. Are we okay with that? Did we just trap our robot? I don't think so, although I could be wrong. This needs to be hydroponics here. Hydroponics. There we go. Great. And then we need a door. Oh. Door right there. And then we will continue mining this area. All right, robot can get to there. Okay.
Storage area.
Living area objects. Beds. First, let's put a heater on the wall. Can we do that, please? No? I think maybe I have to, like, go up to the wall, air vent, space heater. Is that on the other side? I want it in here. Oh, I see. Space heater. Or wait, do I see? Yeah, I feel like these aren't... This isn't like a real room yet.
Rations. No.
Not hydroponics. No living area. All this. I know rations are low. I know. I don't know what our colonists are doing. How is this... How are these walls... Oh, no, 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 no. Dang it. Storage. Right-clicking, man. Storage. I need to get rid of the walls is the issue. How do I get rid of these walls? Wall screen? Door? Generic room casing. Get rid of that. I want it to be a storage area. I don't know what's going on. All right, let's keep making... Extending the living area here. Once he mines this out. Good boy, good robot. Okay. Nice living area. They just need to build it, I think. And the door. And then we should be good. I think. Oh, nope. Right-clicking. Storage. There we go. Right. Okay. Alright, this is good. This looks good. Storage area here. They still have a wall here, but whatever. I don't know if that's just a glitch, what they're doing. Alright, let's play some... Oh, good. Space heater. I want the space heater on this side. Is that where it's being built? No. Oh, there. What? Oh, starvation. Yeah. I guess that was bound to happen. All right, we're putting a space heater there. And then, all right, this is good. We had someone die of starvation. Bound to happen. Let's get some more, hydroponics. Broccoli. Potatoes. Kale. I guess more potatoes. I can just, whoops. No, eat potatoes to their heart's content. Okay. Not a very well-balanced diet, but okay. And then, we need a door here, I think. How is this? Rooms. Living area. This all needs to be living area. It is, right? Okay. Alright, let's get some beds in here. Single beds. I don't know how many colonists we have right now. Four? Okay. Let's do that. One.
Rations.
Two. Three. Four. And then food preparation station. That's the important thing. Yeah, we can put that, like... I'd like to put it closer to the hydroponics, but I think we need this door here first. We need to really, like, open this up. A little confused. I guess we'll just put it right here for now. Okay. And what's up? What's up with that? Yeah, we need, we didn't put the space heater there. Okay, there. Space heater. A toilet. Well, that is nice, isn't it? Let's do that. Probably away from the food preparation station. Right here. Can't be that pretty. We'll wait. They've been living without a toilet for a while. Can I just get rid of a hydroponic? Okay. Alright, what's going on? Where's our robot?
Living area.
Oh, he's still doing the foliage stuff. Okay, we'll probably need more power. Let's get more. And there, whoa, look at all this stuff. Portable solar array. Okay. Interesting, a flag. It turns kinetic energy into patriotism. Wow, look at all this stuff. Turret. Let's build a few wind turbines, I think. There we go. Power's important. And it looks like this place is windy enough. Okay, so we need more materials, which probably means we need to mine, right? We are mining. I don't know what our robot's doing, though. It should be mining this stuff. Let's get rid of this one room casing. Can we do, like, rooms like nothing? Generic? I don't know how we get to that area. Well, I guess we can put another door, like right here. I don't know. I mean, there's a door right. Temperature warning. I don't know how this is supposed to work. Living area. Low temperature. Low temperature in the living area. I mean, I told him to build a space heater. But what can you do? Door here. They've not built a... Man. Let's get more people. Ooh. Bam. Okay. Well, I know this game has not been very... We have people keep dying, although we keep getting more people. So that's fine. Maintain equipment. Process and smelt more minerals. Yeah. So obviously, there's still a lot of stuff we need to do here. Where are they? Look at them coming out of here. Is there just one? V. Williams. Yeah, so I think I'm going to call this an episode. I know it looks like I'm really struggling here, which I am, but this has gone so much better than the first flail through that I tried to record. So I think we will continue this. I think once we get the hang of it, and once I realize like how to actually do the stuff, what not to do, this game could be really fun. And it looks like, you know, every time they do make releases, it does look pretty cool. We have the atmospheric generator here. We have all this stuff. I think we just don't have the materials. We need to mine more. We can't get to where the areas that the robot needs to mine because I don't know how to get rid of, like, the casing. But we'll figure it out. So thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this Let's Play, please leave a like. Please share. If you know how to pause this game, please let me know. Please leave comments. I enjoyed playing with you today, and I will see you next time. Bye, everybody.